Welcome to the Bad Cats Club. Today we're talking about makeup. We're starting off with the panda. First off, you always start makeup by washing your face, making sure it's nice and clean, and moisturizing. Next up, you do all your prep work. If you need to pick your eyebrows, this is the time. Also, I would not recommend putting your costume on before putting your makeup on, because, well, sometimes it crumbles and it falls on your clothes and, well, it's a pain, really. Start off with your foundation. This is an ivory one. It's lighter than my skin tone, but we're going for a really pale look here, so yeah, that's fine. Put it on nice and thick all over your face. The next thing we use is a perfect cover highlighter concealer. And yeah, this also is a medium, lighter than my skin tone, but again, we're going for a really pale look. You put it everywhere that you have natural color increases. Everything that you need to cover up to get a really smooth, nice finish. You smooth it out with your fingertip. Next up, it's time for your foundation powder. It's a matte powder, which really, well, it helps cover up your skin, make it nice and smooth. I'm using the Nude Dream Matte Mousse. It gives you a nice pale look. Put that all over your face, including your lips. And be quite generous with it. Make sure it's nice and smooth and well blended into your hairline. Don't forget your neck and your ears, just to smooth it down. Next up, you take your compact powder. I have a number 12 Sandy, which is, well, again, lighter than my skin tone. Make sure to use a nice clean brush for putting on the powder. This will help seal your makeup and make it less likely to smear. Next up, you take your black eyeliner. And you do a rough outline of what you want to do. It's always good to have a reference picture to work out of. Just go right up to your eyebrow and a little bit beyond, covering the whole upper part of your eye. Try to make both sides symmetrical. This might take some tinkering, but, oh, it's well worth it. Start to fill in the black using your black eyeliner all over the upper part of your eye. Take extra care around the eyelash to make sure you get that last piece of flesh color. Don't forget the insides. Clean up any smudges and make sure you have a nice, clean line. Take your black eyeshadow and put it generously over your black eyeliner. This is to seal it and also give it some extra depth. I was a bit too heavy-handed with putting the black eye blush on my brush, so it ended up on the bottom of my cheek here. But just clean that up using some water. Next up, you take your black liquid eyeliner and you smooth out the edges, making them nice and sharp. Try to keep the symmetry between both eyes. Next up, you take your white eyeliner and you start out by filling in the inside of your lower eyelash. Then start making a rough outline of where the lower part is going to go. Now this part needs to be smaller than the black one. and also straighter. Otherwise, your eyes will look too heavy. Put it all over the bottom part of your eye. Try not to smudge the black. Keep that line nice and crisp. Do it a little bit at a time. Remember, it's always easier to put on more than to take off. Take your white eyeshadow and put it generously on top of your white eyeliner. Again, to seal it and to make the color clearer. Put it all over your lower eyelash as well to make them blend in. Take your liquid eyeliner and draw an outline on the bottom of your white makeup. Again, try to make it as symmetrical as you can. Might want to clean it up with a black eye pencil, just to make that edge nice and sharp. Take your black eyeliner and draw in bottom lashes with a light hand. Now I use just a black eyeliner. Give myself a little bit of a lift. I top that off with a lip gloss that I sort of dabbed on, not so that I wouldn't smear the makeup. Ended up looking a little bit pissed off, and I fixed that by simply making the arch of my eye softer. Pair that with a nice hairdo and the right costume, and you are good to go. Now here's a really simple, quick zombie makeup that anyone can do. Same again, clean face, moisturized. Start off with a compact powder, a light one, to make yourself look nice and pale. Put it everywhere where you have a natural redness of your skin. Chin, your nose, and your forehead, and also the apples of your cheek. If you're having something with a low, if you have something with a low neckline, also have some there. Take a red eyeliner and just start to fill in your natural veins on your neck, but also on your face, to make them stand out more. Now everything that you would normally want to hide with makeup, you now want to highlight. So put that red pen in your creases, follow the natural flow of the bags of your eyes to make them even more prominent. And also your veins on your temples. Take a yellow eyeshadow. I didn't have yellow, so I just used my gold, because really, well, that's what I have. And use it to highlight and enhance the bags under your eyes. You want to use it just under the red to make your eyes look like they're deeper than they are. Just use your finger to blend it. Take your brown eyeshadow. Again, to highlight the natural flow of your eyes. Make them look hollow. A little bit underneath your lower eyelash, not too much. And then outlining the natural bags under your eyes, where your skin is. Also use the brown eyeshadow and accentuate the natural veins on your face, making them more prominent. And in the creases, any creases you have on your face, always blend with the line. If you want, you can also put in a bit of a bruise, starting off with your brown eyeshadow. Filling in your natural creases will make you look pale, but unhealthy. Take your black eyeshadow and just build up the color, deeper, darker, natural transition, where the dark parts would naturally be, but now accentuated, blending with the line. A little bit on the side of your nose will make your eyes seem even more hollowed out, giving you a sunken in look. Put a little bit at the middle of your brows to give it a bit of depth, just everywhere where you would naturally have a line or a shadow on your face to make that deeper and more prominent. Use the black eyeshadow to shadow your veins. You can even make them even more prominent by following what would be a natural line up your neck. Put that black eyeshadow on your cheek. Make sure to follow the natural line of your cheekbone. Right there is your cheekbone. Stay below that. Blend it in, and it will give you a hollow look on your cheeks as well. Again, keep in mind with your cheekbone, right there. Feel it under your skin. Next, I use a dark lip gloss. It's almost purple. And I take a little bit underneath my eyes just to deepen that color. Now you want to be careful with your reds, because you want to look like there's not enough blood in you. A little bit in the middle of the bruise just to deepen it. And along one side to give it a little bit of a shade. Smooth it out. Make sure those veins really pop. Take your black eyeliner and just fill in the creases just a little bit to make sure they seem way too deep for a living, healthy person, following the natural lines on your face. Again, I take my nude foundation and I just put it on my lip so they look pale, like there's no blood in them. Just better up any parts that don't seem right. All your red parts will be more red. All your black parts will be more black if you don't have any circulation in your skin. Pair this with a dead eye look and a kick-ass costume and a lot of fake blood, and you'll be pretty good off. Last up is the doll makeup. Start off with a clean face and moisturize. Pick up your perfect concealer and you put it on nice and thick. You want a really smooth, pale finish, so you can be real generous with this. Put a little bit of soap on my eyebrows just to make the makeup stick better to them. And you just put concealer everywhere on your face where you have natural redness, but also very thickly over your eyebrows. Now you want to allow a little bit of drying time for the soap on your eyebrows, but also for the foundation on them. A few minutes will do fine. I take a cream foundation and I put it on very generously on my face, smoothing out the foundation a little bit before, but not a whole lot, just the edges, really dabbing it more than anything. Make sure you get the foundation pretty much everywhere, even on your lips. Dab it to smooth it out just a little bit on your ears and on your neck, all up to your hairline. Take your Dream at Moose cameo. You also put that on, not as thickly, it's more to seal the foundation in, but enough to give you a nice matte smooth finish. Sure to get it on your neck as well, so you don't have a harsh line there on your jaw. Get your brown eyeshadow. We're using this to make our upper eyelid seem a lot bigger than it is. Just drawing a new eyelid line right between your natural eyelid and your eyebrow. Get your black eyeliner and deepen the crease at the bottom of the brown eyeshadow. Take your black liquid eyeliner and use this as a last step to make it look like a deeper crease, blending it upwards towards the eyeshadow. Get your white eyeshadow, put it all over your eye. Your white eyeliner pen, fill in all along the insides of your eyelashes. Now take a black gel eyeliner and I just use it as a normal eyeliner around the outer parts of my eyelashes. I'm going a little bit too far in the outer part of my eye. Same with the bottom one. Going a little bit too low, but tapering off and letting it meet my natural eyelash. Here's where the false eyelashes come in. Start off with a mascara. Just do your upper eyelashes. Take your eyelash curler and do what you do. Curl them up a bit. Put a bit of glue on the fake eyelash. And you put it on, but not following the natural line of your normal eyelash, following the eyeliner's outer part. Now the eyelashes will stick better if you give them a few seconds for the glue just to get a little bit dry. Now you take your gel eyeliner again and you paint over that edge so that it blends in. Take your liquid black eyeliner and you just paint in the lower eyelash. Take your white eyeliner and you paint the skin that's between the eye and the eyeliner you draw in and just make that seem nice and white. Take your black eyeliner and just above your natural brow, thin line, give yourself very doll-like eyebrows. If you want, you can take some pink rouge and give yourself a nice, just very round, very small, almost painted on apple cheek. Another option is to take your black eyeliner and draw in some freckles that are naturally symmetric. And take a very pink lip gloss, almost red. Give yourself a very small nose. Again, if that's the look you're going for. If you want to do a crack doll, just take your liquid eyeliner and draw in the crack. Make sure the edges are quite sharp. Take your brown eyeshadow and fill in where you want the hole. Take your black gel eyeliner and just shade that up a little bit. Take your liquid eyeliner and just make small additional cracks where they would normally occur in the bends of other cracks. Making sure they taper off and get more narrow before they disappear. Take a step back. Make sure it looks the way you want it to. And you're good.